Buddy, just giving you an update on Emmy. It looks like she's very, very close. We've just had a discharge. Got a bit worried. It's actual emerald green, but apparently that's just a sign that everything's on its way and happening. I've got to monitor it though. So it's just a matter of waiting, keeping the bed updated. She keeps on coming. Every time I leave, she comes and gets me. So I think it's very, very close. This is how she acts when whenever she's pregnant. I get used to it. But it's the first time I've ever seen this green discharge. Apparently, it's from where the placenta is ripped off the wall a little bit. The vet said it's nothing to worry about. Like, she's ready to drop. The pups, she's pushing the pups. She is trying her hardest. But, I'm going to keep my eye on her. It could be today. It could be tomorrow. The vet said not to worry. But if anything else happens, to get back to the vet and everything like that. Only problem is my regular vet can't do, if there is any problem. Yeah, they've got no appointments. So I'm just now trying to get in with the other vet. But I'm lucky there's plenty of vets around here, so I don't have a problem. And from what I know of, they're all pretty good. So yeah, can't be a problem, too much of a problem. But, she's definitely going to have puppies. I'm hoping it is today, but I got so worried when the, and I can't read your comments, by the way, if you're out there watching. So I'm sorry, but yeah, I can't read. I don't know how to do it, actually. It's all the truth. I don't know where the comments come. And a matter of time, folks. That's all it is. It's just a matter of time. I've had red discharges, a yellowish discharge in the past. This is the first time I'd ever experienced the green discharge. So if you do have a dog, that is normal, apparently, when it's really, really close. So, scary, but you get used to stuff like this happening when you're a dog breeder. So I've been breeding dogs for many, many, many years now. I breed pedigree Kelpies, I breed Calamays, I breed cattle dogs. I've bred them all. Done a lot of Kelpie breeding because I used to work up in the farms when I was younger. So I learnt most of the stuff and got the stuff about being a breeder when I was younger. And you know what to expect. There's a lot of thing, like now, even though I'm sitting here, she's resting. And I can talk and it's not going to worry her because I see I'm here. So to her, she's safe. It's weird. Ruby, yes, it's the same. It sort of depends on your closeness to your animals. Like all my dogs have been really, really good. Like, as you can see, this is a whelping bed. This is actually, I've had to clear all that out of the store because I had this chock-a-block full of all these boxes. So I've had to clear them out. This is the temporary room where I've got everything at the moment because my house was mid-reno when I got really sick. But the whelping bed always comes in here anyhow. It's nice. It's cold. It's a very constant temperature. It never gets too cold. It never gets too hot. If it does get too hot, sometimes I might have to put a fan up the end, but it's never too cold. That's the best thing about it. It's sort of, even though it's freezing at the moment. But you can see she's resting. She's really comfortable down there now. She's not having any contractions. Maybe I spoke too soon. But she is in the process of pushing the pups. And I know the pups are very, very soon because of that. There was no form except for the shape of the nipple up until yesterday. And that's also another sign that the pups are near, because the teats aren't just teats anymore. They're actual, nipples. And and they've got shape to them. So that means she's very, very near. The way she's acting, pushing against the wall, it's a clear sign that she's using the wall to brace herself when she pushes. And she's a good dog, aren't you? You're a good girl, aren't you, Emmy? He's a good girl? Is Emmy a good girl? Yeah. She knows they're coming. She's just sitting there nice and calm. She's taking a break. And but she loves being told she's a good girl, aren't you? Is you a good girl? Is you going to have puppies? Are we going to have puppies today? Is the puppies coming today or tomorrow? But anyhow, darling, you be a good girl, okay? You be a good girl, all right? So that's what's going on, everybody. If you want to watch the pups constantly, you need to go over to Ruby and Emerald's Puppy Watch channel. The link will be in the description in about 5 minutes as soon as I do the thing. Unfortunately, still got all those restream problems and everything, still trying to solve those and the multi-streaming issue. I have been a little bit sick, so that's why you haven't really seen me that much. Injured my back at the hospital, which is all new about. And then unfortunately, as I got over that, first day back at college, went shopping afterwards and someone sneezed on me and I wound up in bed with a bloody flu for 4 weeks. So, yeah, that's an update on me and Lady Emerald. And, she's quite happy. If I leave, I guarantee you she's going to follow me in the other room because she's so close. This, to her, is protection. Me sitting here, she knows she's dead safe. Look at her. I'm talking. She's gone off to sleep. And most probably the first sleep she's had all night. And she comes to me whenever she wants protection. She just came into the other room a second ago and wouldn't leave until I followed her. So I followed her. And that's generally one of the last signs that she's going to drop a pup very soon. And that's what I'm praying for. But as I said, if you want to watch the puppy watch thing, I'll put the link in the description of the video. So don't close the video. It will be in the description and as soon as I stop the video, so give it a couple of minutes before you close the video, refresh the page, and the link to the Puppy Watch channel, if you don't have it already, will be in the description of this video. Unfortunately, when I go live from this phone, I can't put a description in there. So she'll be fine. She'll be fine. As I said, it was just that green discharge that scared the shit out of me. So been on the phone to one vet, going to get on the phone to another just to get them up to date and just in case I need to go to the vet. And this is the whole reason I monitor is, see, if I didn't know it, see, that can still be seen. And it's bloody emerald green. And I'm not joking. That's emerald green. Same color as an emerald. And that's the discharge coming out. So that means there's separation in the placenta wall. So at least one pup is coming. So, it's just, placenta fluid, really. You don't normally see something like that until the very, very end. But sometimes you see it at the beginning. As you can see, she's very comfortable. She's quite happy there. Having a sleep, she knows I'm here watching her and she's okay. But I guarantee if you go to the Puppy Watch channel and I leave here, she'll be, when I go to put the description, the link to the puppy channel, I guarantee you she'll follow me at some stage and tell me to come back in. But I'm used to this. This is part and parcel of the life of being a dog breeder sometimes. As long as you have somewhere safe for your pups. And as you can notice, too, talking about that, safety for the pups, like these are like full-width sheets of plywood that I've got attached to the back of my my wine racks. So I've actually screwed into the rear of the wine racks to keep it stable, screwed this one to the wall because this is a that's where the old window used to be. This is going to be my new bathroom, by the way, this section here, from about another 2 feet behind me to the wall. Going to soon be a bathroom, I hope. And, yeah, and it's actually going to have a space where I can set up a whelping bed in it. And that I've always got a whelping space, no matter what, and I always make it out of the same material because I don't want anything falling on my dog. I don't want anything happening to my dog. I want her to know that when she's there, she's 100% safe. And I mean 100% safe, because you've got to think about the dog. She's got to be comfortable. She's got to be – some dogs won't even let you sit near them when they're having the pups. They'll wait and then go off in the room and have the pups or whatever. So you've just got to make sure that you've got something like this. I go through bedding fairly in this stage. Yeah, I go through a fair bit on washing sheets and stuff like that on a constant basis. What she doesn't destroy, she's already destroyed the sheet she's on. She's destroyed the other side. I've had to flip it over because she's ripped it. She's starting to discharge fluid, so that's another sign, as you can see here. That's a bit of fluid discharge down this end. Yeah, the way I've got the bed set up, I can just flip the sheets around if one side gets too dirty and get a double use out of it, which you should think of stuff like that when you're doing it. I've got nice, soft dog cushions underneath her, and like good quality ones. I don't use shit. You watch. Yeah, she's messing with the bed. So I've got really good quality dog bedding underneath her. And then I've got blankets, I've got a wet one to catch all the fluids, and my good blanket. I had to donate one of my good blankets to her today, but she's worth it. She's definitely worth it, but that's what goes on when you're a breeder. You've got to get used to it. And let's just say, make sure you put the whelping bed in a room that has an air extraction system. Trust me, you need an air extraction, especially once the pups are born, because the pups will remain here for quite a few weeks. And so it's expandable. So I can expand this one more dog bed. It's set up for the width of three dog beds side by side. And it's the exact width of the length of the dog bed, so I just drop them in, and a normal sheet will cover all three. So, but at the moment, I've only got the two in there because she hasn't had the pups yet. And yeah, so that's an Emmy update. And yeah, I'm going to put this in the description now, and go to the puppy channel and watch the puppy. It's called, if you want to find it before I get there, it's called Ruby and Emerald's Puppy Watch. So that's the channel name, and yeah, I'll see you there. All right, ciao everybody, and I'll catch you later. Bye.